Hey, Fritz with Fritzy Brothers One Man Circus here with Jay Mattioli, and you probably just saw some of his magic. Jay, this is your first time at Pasco County Fair?
First time at the world famous Pasco County Fair.
And what did you think?
It's awesome. It's great. You know, it's a fair. It has that warm, you know, down-home feel. It seems like something that it's a tradition in Pasco County. It seems like this is something people come to every year, and they bring their family. And we had a roller coaster with the weather of it being hot and super cold for this time of year, and then it warmed up again right for the final 2 days. So overall, I think it was a success. I had a blast.
Great. I was gonna ask him about his hair, but
that looks exactly like it.
I was
just like Edward Scissorhands. That animator needs a prize.
I was gonna ask him about his hair, but we already saw how he did that one of the acts.
I just drive down the highway with all the windows down.
I'm ready! Jay, what I wanna know is, what was the first thing that you thought, oh my gosh, I've gotta learn how to do this, I wanna be a magician? What was that sparked it in you?
It's hard to remember because I have a brother who's 2 years older than me. So when we were little kids, I remember seeing him get books from the library on magic, and I couldn't really read or comprehend what I was reading. So I would just mimic him, what he was doing. He was learning little magic tricks, you know, out of a book. And we were big fans of David Copperfield, and in the 1980s and 90s, he always had a show on TV every year. And so we would record it with the VHS, and then I guess I can remember being a little kid, like, mimicking David Copperfield poses and things like that, but I wasn't really doing magic, but I was trying to get that style down, even as a little kid. I remember that a lot, just trying to mimic David Copperfield and my brother, you know, even if I was doing nonsense, you know.
And as you saw, we saw a little bit of that
nonsense. Yes, you saw a lot of
a little bit of that nonsense on stage. And now you're married, correct?
Yeah.
And kids?
Yep.
How many kids do you have?
Two that I know of. Two.
And as far as what are their ages?
Three and a half. He's going to be four, and the other one is seven.
Okay. And so for the most part, you're probably not traveling a whole lot. Is that correct?
At this point, it's about a third of the year I'm away from home. Working on a plan to kind of cut that down a little bit, give or take 125 to 150 days a year, something like that.
Okay. And you were on America's Got Talent.
I was on America's Most Wanted, correct. Got Talent, correct.
I actually appeared on the first season.
Oh, cool.
I went to New York, and all that they showed was me on a unicycle going, whoa, in front of the camera, and it would show that coming back from the commercial, but I never made it to
to
the
just
show.
Like some B-roll. Hey, but that's all right.
What was your experience with that? What did do you feel
it was
that
over
it helped
10,
you at all?
Yeah, or? Of course. It was over 10 years ago. Not really something I really, it's almost irrelevant at the moment of, in my life and what I'm doing, but I certainly wear it as a badge of honor, I guess, underneath everything. Overall, it was a good experience. It's very stressful. You make it to the live rounds, it's live television, and then it's television and show business, as you know. You might think you did well, and for whatever particular reason, you're out. Or the opposite could happen. You might have thought it didn't go so well, and for whatever reason, they liked you, and you're in. I mean, that's show business. Remember, it's television, and you gotta remember what is, you know, what's the trend on television? How do we consume entertainment? Nowadays, a lot of people, they consume entertainment right there on their phones. So, it's gotten to a point where almost every bit of art, a lot of it is almost cliche without the emotional background with it. Then all of a sudden it becomes unique and personal. And the producers of those type shows are, I think, very smart to hone in on that. And I think having those human interest stories where you hear about this hardship background story, it makes you relate to this person because we all know the burden of having a hardship. And then to see them triumph with this talent that they have, I think it's very smart, those reality shows that kind of hone in on that. Some people say some of that stuff is not really fair, but at the end of the day, they're trying to make the best piece of entertainment for television, not find the best talented artist.
Right.
It's a little different.
So where is home for you?
I live just west of Washington, D.C. in Virginia.
What is the best way for someone to think, man, I saw some of this show on a tape. How can I get Jay to come to my event? What's the best way to get a hold of you?
They can go to www.jay, that's J, Mattioli, MATTIOLI.com. And on there is my website. You can find me on Facebook, on social media. You can contact me directly. That's the easiest way to get in touch with me. And anyone just wants to say hello, same thing. You could just search my name and you'll find me, the one and only me. I don't think there's any imposters yet.
Stephen Paul with Fritzy Brothers One Man Circus with Jay Mattioli. Say goodbye, Jay.
Peace.
Don't forget to click the like button, subscribe, and make a comment.